Yo, what's going on, dudes? My name is Prestige. Welcome back to the channel. Today, we're going to talk about the patch that just came out last night for Infinite Warfare. Some of these changes brought some nerfs, as well as buffs, as well as some characteristic changes to epic weapons that I may have already covered here on the channel. So if you're wondering why your weapon's not working the same like it used to, or if it's working a little bit better than it used to, hopefully this video will help you out. We're going to start the conversation with weapons, and then I'm going to move into rigs. If you guys want to follow along, or if you want to check out the official patch for yourself, I'll put a Reddit link down below in the description. But let's get started on weapons. The Hailstorm overall got a decrease to fire time between bursts, but it also got a slight increase to its damage range. That was kind of the give and take. It got a little bit of a nerf, but it also got a little bit of a buff. The DCM8 shotgun, which is what I'm using in this gameplay, also received a slight buff. It got increased damage and damage range, but I really don't notice a big difference. Considering this is fully automatic, it still needs to be within the realm of reasonable. Moving down the list, we have the MACTAB 45. Slight increase to the recoil while firing, aiming down sight. The M1 got a slight decrease in return speed when firing, aiming down sight. And finally, the Howitzer got an update for its direct impact kill challenges. And I can confirm they have been fixed. I started the challenges last night. I thought they were going to be hell in a handbag. And I ended up actually getting about 100 of them last night. And it was super easy to do. So that's not a big deal anymore. Now moving into the elite variants that changed. I'm using the DCM8 Masochist in this particular video for the sake of talking about this weapon itself. The lifelink perk before used to just contain infinite ammo. You never had to reload, you never had to do anything of the sort, but while you were using it, it would hurt you at the same time. This has been changed completely. You get a large magazine size, I believe it gives you 24 rounds, and from there, if you take any type of damage, if you get shot once, if you get hit by a grenade, any type of damage you take, your magazine will fully regenerate instantaneously. I almost feel like this is better in the sense that if you're worried about dying by using this weapon, you don't have to anymore. This is one of those weapons that I haven't actually done a video on yet, so stay tuned for it and we'll talk a little bit more about it. Moving down the list, we have the Banshee Siren. Shockwave perk has been updated. So now you get improved damage while sliding, and the damage itself will still cause hearing loss. That's pretty interesting. So while sliding and using this weapon, your damage is going to be increased. I haven't really used this weapon yet, so I'm not sure what it was like before. The EBR 800 Osiris was updated, and you will no longer get a sniper glint with this weapon, which is very interesting, and enemies at low health are still going to be highlighted. So these are all pretty much buffs so far from what I'm considering. Now, the next one is, I understand why they did it, but at the same time, I don't know. The Kendall 44 Cartel. This is the weapon that you unlock by doing the Wraith mission teams, and they changed the secondary perk to stability so you can have less recoil. It's basically like having a foregrip attached to your weapon. Before, it used to be steady, and this allowed you to hip fire a lot better. The whole point behind the Kendall 44 is aiming down sight, because you're able to keep the same exact movement speed while aiming down sight. It's like having a built-in stock, but a lot better. So I can understand why they changed that. They moved that steady perk to the Kendall 44 advantage, so now if you want to hip fire to your heart's content, you can definitely do it there over on the advantage. Now moving on down the list, there is a small error here. It says the DMR1 Scout, but what they're referring to is the DMR1 Spectacle. And this basically gives you the DMR1 with a built-in reflex sight. Now what they did was they allowed the reflex sight to have a built-in tracking chip and improve aim down sight time for all scopes. I went and tested this in game. The ADS time is actually pretty quick. I would compare it to the M1 that you can get with a classic weapon token. And that's pretty good, especially if you're somebody just going specifically for headshots, or if you want to use this thing more aggressively than you used to be able to. The sniper glint is still there, unfortunately. I feel like this weapon would have benefited more than the Osiris, but then again, I completely understand why they did it with that weapon. Moving on down the list, we have the Rack 9 Smoothbore. The one-shot kills at medium range will now include the lower torso as well as arms, so you're going to see a lot more one-shot kills. And finally, we have the Mauler Mammoth. This epic weapon is one of my favorites, and they gave it a small nerf. slower aim down sight time, and reduced movement speed. Wah, wah. So if you really wanted to use this thing to your advantage, once again, you could always use the man-at-arms trait with the combat rig merc, and you'll be all good to go. Now let's talk about rig payloads. A lot of these things ended up getting nerfed, and we're talking phase shift, rewind, overdrive. All of them were increased to 90 seconds. Now, we're talking specifically if you're just sitting there, not getting kills, not capturing objectives, it's gonna take a total of 90 seconds to get that. The only buff out of all of this has been to the Gravity Vortex. It takes 310 seconds to actually earn that thing without doing anything, and it's been decreased to 290 seconds. So you're gonna be able to earn that Gravity Vortex a little bit faster. Reactive armor health was reduced from 133 hit points down to 114. That's a couple of shots off of there, so you're not going to see a major benefit to the reactive armor like you used to. Unfortunately, the reactive armor got hit with a double whammy. The duration was also reduced from 9 seconds down to 7 seconds. The same thing happened with active camo. It was reduced from 10 seconds down to 7 seconds. So if you're trying to use your active camouflage to get from point A to point B, you better be doing it quick because you might be seen or might be revealed by the time that 7 seconds is up. Phantom also received another nerf to the Pulsar. Pulsar, of course, is kind of like Vision Pulse from Black Ops 3. The cooldown was increased from 120 seconds to 150 seconds. So it's going to take you a little bit longer to actually earn that thing. And then you'll also notice that the marked time was reduced as well. It used to be 6 seconds, and now it's only 5 seconds. Not a big difference, but that 1 second could make a difference if someone's right in front of you and they end up just disappearing. You don't know where they're at. So those are all of the changes I really wanted to talk about. This was a pretty big update. They also fixed a lot of the stuff in the zombies. Like, they updated the smiley so you can't use it infinitely like you were before. Just sit in a corner and kind of like grind your way to victory. That's unfortunate. The other thing is they fixed the Hasselhoff so you'd be able to earn him. And they increased how fast you can earn keys, which is really, really nice to have. But overall, I think this update is pretty interesting because it shows that not only are they capable of tweaking specific weapons and changing the way an epic weapon works, but it also shows that they are kind of willing to bring more damage to shotguns, reduce some damage on specific weapons. I mean, there are a lot of things that can go back and forth, and we all have our own kind of feeling on things, but I think we can all agree that shotguns definitely still need a buff. Well, let me know what you guys think down below in the comment section. If you enjoyed the video here today, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe for more awesome videos coming each and every day. Until next time, my friends, I will see ya.
Peace.